Want to create onboarding with paging views? Well, you're in luck, because in this tutorial, I will show you how to do that exactly in Swift. Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Welcome to the channel, and I want you to hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. So let's jump into the demo project, and let me just build and run this so we can see what we are going to build out today. Of course, we are going to do this from scratch. Now, paging views, and we are going to page through three views. As you can see, page one, page two, of course, we are counting from zero. And I'm going to tell you a neat little trick how you can page through the UIPageControl. So here it is. As you can see, let's scroll all the way to page through. How awesome is that? Okay, so let's start off from scratch. Let's go Xcode, file, new, and project. There it is. Let me just resize this so you can see it really, really nicely. Okay, so there it is. Make sure you check select app, next, and let's add a title here for the product name. Okay, paging views tutorial. Make sure you select storyboard here, and of course UIKit app delegate. Okay, let's click on next there, and the language should be Swift, of course. Let's add it here. I'm going to create a Git repository on my Mac, and I'm going to upload this to GitHub. So make sure to check out the link in the description for the resources where you will find everything that you need for this demo project. So first thing first, let's remove the main.storyboard, move to trash. Also from here, let's go to info. Let's add some space here so we can see those buttons here. I mean, these minus and plus buttons, let's remove that. And now go to view controller. You already know this. Oh, by the way, let's go to scene delegate first. And let's create a window scene. If you already know what I'm doing here, go ahead and check out the timestamps on the video, because I'm always doing this. So window equals UI window. And you might already know this, how to kind of remove the main.storyboard. So window.make key and visible. And by the way, those timestamps are really, really nice. So window root view controllers equals our view controller. And basically that's it. We are ready to start off with a brand new project. Okay, so I'm just going to add in from the resources, a few files here. So just the helpers, UI label plus, UI view plus, and UI view plus. These are basically just layout helpers. And we also have, let's see, pin to view, edge to view, and edge to view for the UI scroll view. And I'm also added here a scroll to, where, because we are going to scroll to a certain page on that scroll view. So yeah, really nice and really helpful extensions here. So basically that's it. You can find these files in the description link in the resources. So let's go to our view controller and let's build this out from scratch. First of all, let's create those views. So I'm just going to create them as a lazy variable, and let's name this view zero. And by the way, you will be able to add any, this is a UI view, sorry for that. So you will be able to add any sub views to these views. So this is my approach to it. You might find it really, really helpful. So let view equals UI view there. Let's initialize it and let's add a space in here. And let's return this view. Return view. There we go. And let's initialize it. There we go. We have view zero. Now I will customize this view and then I'm just copy and paste and change some stuff for the other views. So first thing, I want to add the background. So view dot background color equals, let's say, system teal. And then simply let's add a label in center. So let label equals UI label. Now this label will have a text, and the text will have page 0, not pab page. Now here is the place where you can add or customize your view. Now this scrolling paging views might be really helpful in an onboarding screen or whatever you see it fit. But yeah, go ahead and add the subviews right over here. Now I want to have this labels text alignment to be center. And yeah, basically let's add that to our view, like view zero, view dot add subview dot label, and this is label. And then I'm going to use the extension that I created, h2 view. This is plain old layout. So yeah, you go ahead and take a look at it. It's plain simple. So what I'm going to do is just make two copies of this and rename the view and one. And let's have here system ping, why not? And view two here and page two. And let's have here system yellow. Really, really nice. Now it's time to create an array of these views because, yeah, why not? I'm not just going to grab them individually. So again, we are going to create lazy variables because we want to create an array of these views and we want to be able to basically access them. So view zero, view one, and finally view two. How awesome is that? Now it's time to create our scroll view. And views, sorry about that, it's views, because the view is basically the UI view controller's view. Okay, now let's create our scroll view, and that will also be a lazy variable because I want to add some properties to it while we initialize it. So I would just name this scroll view, and that will be of type UI scroll view. Let's create that, and let scroll view equals UI scroll view. And let's return that and let's initialize it. Let me just move this a little bit up so you can see. Oh, we want to return the scroll view. There it is. So what do we want to do with this scroll view? Well, first of all, let's remove the horizontal scroll indicator. I really don't like it. And on an onboarding, it's really annoying. So we just want to hide it. So scroll shows horizontal scroll indicator. Let's set this to false. Okay, now for the paging effect, you want to enable pagination. So scroll view is paging enabled. Let's set this to true. How awesome is that? Now we want to set the next thing we want to do is set the content size of the scroll view. As you know, or maybe you don't, but a scroll view has a size, which is basically the size that you can see on your screen, and it has a content size, and that is basically what, including what you don't see in the scroll view. Okay, so let me just type this out. It will be really obvious. So scroll view content size, there it is. And this will be a CG size. And let's choose the one with the CG floats. And yeah, we want to have the width to be the view's width multiplied by the times of how many views I actually have for that onboarding. And let me just type this out. It's really simple. View.frame.width. This is how we get the view's width. And we are going to multiply it by our views.count. And this is an integer, so we want to add in here CG float. So we do have that multiplication available. Okay, and for the height, you want to just simply have CG float with a capital F. There we go. And for the height, view.frame.height. Okay, so that will be the content size. Now we want to go through all of the views and we want to add them so to our scroll view. So for I, and I'm using this for loop because I do want to grab the actual index of the views. So for I in 0, till the views dot count, of course, minus one, because that's how you should do that. And what should we do? Let's first add this view to the scroll view. So scroll view dot add sub view, and I'm going to grab the views and just use the I for the current view that I'm adding here. Now we want to grab create a frame for our view. So views I frame dot frame equals, it will be a CG rect. There we go. And let's just use this with the floats. So X should be basically the, well, where we are pinning it. So view dot frame dot width multiplied by CG float I. And I think this is self-explanatory. Y should be always zero. We don't want to move it on the y-axis. And the width, again, view.frame.width, because we want to fill out the full screen. And view.frame.height. So yeah, that will be the views frame. Well, all of the views that we are adding to the scroll view. And yeah, while we are here, let's add a delegate. So scroll view dot delegate equals self. Okay, so yeah, let's just add the delegates right now before we add some more stuff. Okay, now for the delegate, let's just scroll all the way down and let's create an extension. So extension on the view controller and UI scroll view delegate. Oh, sorry about that. Scroll view delegate. There it is. And we are going to implement the scroll view did scroll. So scroll view did scroll. This one. Okay. And I'm just going to use this in just a second. I just added this delegate because Xcode will scream at me if I don't add the delegate functions. Okay, so now what we want to do is in the view did load, we basically want to add that scroll view to the view controller's view. So that is pretty straightforward. View dot add subview scroll view. This is how we add subview, and then we want to edge it. And we with auto layout, go ahead and check out those extensions. So scroll view edge to our view. Now this view is the view controller's view, as you already know. So let's just build and run this and see how this looks. Maybe I have some errors there. Hopefully they will disappear. And yeah, now we should see those three pages and we can just scroll through them, through paginations. We do have some errors, but what kind of errors do we have here? Oh yeah, the window scene. You most probably saw that while I was typing, I wasn't that attentive. Okay, so build has succeeded. Yeah, page one, okay. Let me just remove my typos here and build and run again. Yeah, I'm always kind of trying to explain and I have these typos. So there we go. We have these nice paging effects. But let's just make this a little bit more exciting. Let's add page control. So that will be really, really easy to do. Let's go right above the view didot. Let's create our page control. So lazy var again, page control equals UI page control. There we go. Well, not equals, of type UI page control, because the equals has to be added there. So let page control equals UI page control. And let's return that page control and let's initialize it right over there. Okay, so let's add a number of pages. So page control dot number of pages equals our views count, basically views.count. And we want to add a target whenever we kind of change the page on that page control. So page control dot add target, and let's add in here self. For the selector, we want to create a new function here, and that will be an Objective-C function. And let's name this maybe page control tap handler. Okay, and let's add the sender here. So sender UI page control. There we go. And yeah, for now, let's just add this into control tap handler. There we go. And let's create a selector here. Let's add that in here, and we want to add also the sender. Okay, so that's how we do it, and we want to fire this on TouchUp inside. TouchUp inside. Okay, so yeah, basically that's it. What do we want to do when the page control was kind of touched up, when we release that touch? We basically want to scroll our scroll view, so scroll view dot scroll to, and let's just use our horizontal page here, sender dot, I think it's current page. Yes, it is. No vertical page needed here, and animated true. And finally, we want to add this page control to our view hierarchy, and let's just do that in the view did load. So view dot add subview and page control. And on the page control, we want to pin to our view. Now this will pin this to the bottom. Go ahead and check out the extension so you really know how that is done. Okay, so finally, let's build it on and see what we got here. So here is our page control, and yeah, we want to kind of push it all together because now it's not updating when I'm swiping, but it is going to swipe when I'm going to just go ahead and kind of touch up inside on the page control. Really, really nice. So let's do that final step, and let's just go down to the scroll view, did scroll, and yeah, we just need to update these page controls. So what we want to get is the page index when we are scrolling on the scroll view, and that we are going to grab from the content offset of X and the frame of our view. So let me just type this out, it's much more easier. So page index. And we are going to round this up, and scroll view dot content offset, content offset, there it is, dot x, and divided by our views dot frame dot width. Basically, well, this is when we are going to, okay, we are at this page, and on the page control, we want to set the current page to be an integer of that page index. Okay, and maybe on the page control, you want to set the current view, page control, current page equals zero, because yeah, you might want to start with that. So let's build and run and see how this looks. And finally, we will have what we wanted to achieve. So whenever I just go and scroll over there, we have that, and now let's swipe to scroll. Really, really nice updating the page control. Paging views are so awesome, and they can be used outside of an onboarding also. So, if you did like this video, go ahead and hit that notification bell. And if you do want to have some extra stuff, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where I can teach you one-on-one on a Zoom call. Now, while you do that, make sure to check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift UI in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.